Hi everyone and welcome to my channel. I'm so happy to have you back. I hope you're all doing well. Today's reading is yet another channel love messages from your person. So it's a general reading for the collective for all star signs. So take what resonates and leave the rest. But if this video found you, then there should be a message in here for you. So let's see what that message is for you today, my dears, about what does your person wants to tell you. Okay, what do they want to tell you? What messages we have? I need to figure myself out. So your person is saying that they need to work on themselves because they're dealing with something, you know. Also, I say here with the way I have treated you was wrong. It's like they've realized that they treated you the wrong way. And they need to figure themselves out because it cannot happen, you know, that way anymore. Like they don't want to treat you that way anymore. They've realized it's wrong. Why do I feel this? Why? So, you know, they're even struggling and they're just kind of like affected by the fact that they feel this way and they don't like themselves. I'm sensing that they're saying that I don't like myself. I don't like that I treated you that way. I know it's wrong. I need to figure myself out. I don't know why I feel this way. Okay. Painful memories. So they're saying that there are some painful memories that I feel like it's making them feel that way, like past wounds, trauma, you know. I feel like that's kind of falling into that category. And they're just saying that there are some painful memories, you know, that they need to figure out. Wow, childhood trauma. Like, that's it. That's it. It's like exactly what I was just saying. They are basically expressing that there are some childhood trauma that they need to work with. That they need to work through, actually. Okay. I am the man. So if this is resonating and your person is, you know, a man and it's, you know, like, is portraying themselves like they consider themselves a man and they're just like in, or they could be in a strong masculine energy depending on everyone, of course. But if your person is resonating, you know, with the message that they carry themselves out as a man, right? They identify as men. They're just saying that, you know, they are the man. They should be the person that's showing up as a man, right? That is treating you, you know, the right way, that they should be, you know, embodying that energy, you know, of the masculine energy, if not, like, however this might resonate with you. But basically, they want to show up as the men that they identify as, right? That they are. But if it doesn't resonate, don't worry too much about it, okay? But basically, they are just trying to show up more, to show more support, right? Which is masculine energy, to show more action, to be more invested, okay? And be more in charge of themselves, right? Or to show more, like, support. I'm obsessed with you. So they're also saying that they're obsessed with you, that they have super strong feelings for you, my dear. Okay, they have like very, very strong attraction and passion for you. Now let's move on to your tarot cards and get to see more about what does your person want to tell you. Okay, what do they want to tell you? So, the Tower, okay. Wow, Five of Cups. This is super strong energy. Seven of Swords, Two of Pentacles, and the Six of Pentacles. So, my dear, I can feel here very, very strongly that there is the energy of needing to let go of a past that hurt them. Okay, they're saying that I have in the past, right? Like Five of Cups is about looking back in the past at the spilled cups, at these painful memories, you know, that created this childhood trauma, that created these wounds and this trauma for them, which is making them turn their back towards the cups that are there for them, which is you, which is this love, this connection, you know, the ability to open up, to be invested, okay, to treat you the right way. And I sense here that this kind of epiphany or this realization really hit them as a wall with this Tower energy, which came as a surprise, but in a bad way. Maybe it was you like deciding to break up. Maybe it was you like cutting them off. Maybe it was you like saying, look, we need to separate for a while, or at least to take a break. Like, it really felt that their whole world is crumbling with the Tower. Okay, and everything is just like on fire, right? Like everything is destroyed and they just feel lost and without having a stable ground. And they realize that, you know, I actually have a responsibility of this, right? To take into how I treated you and it was wrong. I see in here that they're like, they keep juggling between trying to find their balance, right? And this trauma, these wounds and certain behaviors, right? Seven of Swords also showing that they've been really hurt in the past, okay? Or they've been, you know, in such a like raised up in a family or in a situation, they've been part of a situation that really like affected their possibility and their ability to trust, because Seven of Swords comes with lack of trust or being deeply hurt, being lied to, cheated on, you know, like, of course, but we're talking here more about childhood trauma. So from that perspective, like they grew up with the lack of trust or inability to trust, and maybe they've acting a certain way, right? From this fear of trust. And the Six of Pentacles shows that they want to apologize, they want to come forward to do the right thing, to show more of like, yeah, like more support, more investment, like more of that masculine energy of bringing support to the table and being like someone who you can rely on, okay? And the balance is also something that they want to feel more balanced, more like stable, okay, emotionally within themselves, right? I am the man, I should be like a solid rock, stable, right? And the Six of Pentacles shows that they want also to have enough from which they can offer you, but also it's showing that they're gonna come forward with more a commitment or apology. Let's move on to your Oracle's wedding. This situation involves marriage. So maybe you're married to this person and you're in separation, or you ask for a divorce, which could definitely show and you know, confirm why their whole world seems on fire and like crumbling. Maybe this is a connection where, you know, yeah, like things are involving marriage and there is like a lack of trust, right? Maybe it's like a marriage that happened, you know, in the past as well and created this. That's why they're juggling between many things at once, like true responsibilities, depending on how this resonates. We have here retreat. It's time to disconnect from the world. So they realize that it's time for them to take a step back, to disconnect, to retreat, and to work on themselves. Stay optimistic about your love life. Positive thinking and faith will bring you romance. They're trying to stay optimistic. They're trying to stay positive that, you know, their love life won't suffer and this connection might actually have a future. And if they're remaining positive, you know, things are actually going to fall into place. Okay, the snake, competition, enemy, clever, malicious look over your shoulder, the other woman. So it does show that there is a sense of competition with someone else, a sense of mistrust, okay, which they need to like work onto. They're also saying that's their problem, okay? Hand of cards, take a chance, risk, being strategic, options, not showing hand gambling. So they always were acting, you know, from a place of not showing like hand, right? Like not showing their true colors, their true feelings. They were always like maybe afraid to open up. And I sense here that they're saying that I'm ready to take a chance. I'm ready to risk, okay? I was being too like maybe closed off. I wasn't like entirely open. I wasn't giving everything that I have. Not enough. Frustrated in relationship. Lack of confidence, self-sabotage, fear, ego issues, jealousy. Again, yes. So they were jealous. They were really jealous. They had issues, you know, with confidence, with trusting, with feeling stable in themselves. They were constantly frustrated in relationship. They have a lack of confidence and it stems from childhood trauma. They realize that they sabotage themselves. They are sabotaging themselves and they have the fear ego issues. Yeah, so it looks like a person is just saying that these are their issues, that these are what they're dealing with. But at the same time, they need to figure themselves out. They realize that, but they have feelings for you. They're obsessed with you, okay? But this obsession could lean, of course, into like too much, like, right? Too obsessed, like it could be like feelings that are so intense and it blends with the jealousy. So it's not healthy. And I'm sensing here that they have a hard time letting go of something from the past, which is affecting them from, you know, being the kind of person that they should be today. All right, so this is everything that I have for you today, my dears. I really hope you found your answers and you value in the reading. If you did, don't forget to hit like and also subscribe to the channel to not miss any of my future readings. Thank you so much for watching, and I hope to see you in my next one. Until then, take care. Bye-bye.